morning.
Good morning.
And happy Sunday. Thank you for joining together so we can worship God as one body. Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Please join me in saying, Almighty God, to you our hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, whose blessed Son made himself known to his disciples in the breaking of the bread, open the eyes of our faith that we may behold him in all his redeeming work, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. I invite you to be seated for our readings.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter addressed the people, "You Israelites, why do you wonder about this, or why do you stare at us as though by our own power or piety we had made him walk? The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our ancestors, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and rejected in the presence of Pilate, though he had decided to release him. But you rejected the Holy and Righteous One and asked to have a murderer given to you, and you killed the author of life, whom God raised from the dead. To this we are witness, and by faith in his name itself has made this man strong, whom you see and know, and the faith that is through Jesus has given him this perfect health in the presence of all of you. And now, friends, I know that you acted in ignorance, as did also your rulers. In this way, God fulfilled what he had foretold through all the prophets, that his Messiah would suffer. Repent, therefore, and turn to God so that your sins may be wiped out." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We'll read Psalm 4 alternately by half verse. Answer me when I call, O God, defender of my cause. You set me free when I am oppressed. Have mercy on me and hear my prayer. You mortals, how long will you dishonor my glory? How long will you worship dumb idols and run after false gods? Know that the Lord does wonders for the faithful. When I call upon the Lord, he will hear me. Tremble then, and do not sin. Speak to your heart and silence upon your bed. Offer the appointed sacrifices. Put your trust in the Lord. Many are saying, oh, that we might see better times. Lift up the light of your countenance upon us, O Lord. You have put gladness in my heart, more than when grain and wine and oil increase. I lie down in peace. At once I fall asleep. For only you, Lord, make me dwell in safety.
A reading from the first letter of John. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure. Everyone who commits sin is guilty of lawlessness. Sin is lawlessness. You know that he was revealed to take away sins, and in him there is no sin. No one who abides in him sins. No one who sins has either seen him or known him. Little children, let no one deceive you. Everyone who does what is right is righteous, just as he is righteous. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. Jesus stood among the disciples and said to them, "Peace be with you." They were startled and terrified and thought they were seeing a ghost. He said to them, "Why are you frightened? And why do doubts arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet. See that it is I myself. Touch me and see, for a ghost does not have flesh and bones as you see that I have." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While in their joy they were disbelieving and still wondering, he said to them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate it in their presence. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." This is the gospel of our Lord and Savior. Let us strive to be the voice, heart, hands, and feet of Jesus Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Back in 2015, I traveled to Haiti to dedicate the new school we built from St. Mark's. I was excited. I was excited about having raised enough money to build the school. I was excited that we hired Haitians to perform the work. The Haitians did everything from managing the operation to mixing the cement, from laying the cinder blocks to installing the floor and the roof. This allowed them to take ownership and have pride in their new school. I was proud. I was proud that we had the insight to build the school in a basement that worked as a cistern, which would collect thousands and thousands of gallons of rainwater from the roof that would ultimately be pumped into a purification system to provide clean drinking water for all the people in the surrounding villages. I was so proud. I was proud of the accomplishment and the dream achieved in less than 3 years into the partnership. I was proud. I must admit, I was proud, a bit overproud, a bit arrogant and filled with self-importance. I was ready for the dedication, and I was proud that I had my sermon or my homily prepared in Creole. I wanted to show my gratitude and my pride to our Haitian neighbors and to our donors and to the Episcopal Academy for the support they provided for this project. I was proud. Then my counterpart, Père Jeannot, reminded me we need to give thanks to God. Père Jeannot is a great priest. He's a great priest not because he is a great administrator. He is a great priest not because he just cares for his people. He is a great priest not because he understands the value of partnerships. Père Jeannot is a great priest simply because he is full of gratitude. His entire life as a priest constantly points to the living God, to the living God whose grace makes all things possible. He is completely Christ-centered. So when he shared with me what he was planning to say at the dedication, his words jolted me into realizing how short-sighted I was in failing to recognize God in this wonderful accomplishment. It was as if the Holy Spirit came out of the sky and slapped me upside my head. As if the Holy Spirit was saying, it is only by God's grace you are able to accomplish anything. It is only by God's grace you are able to accomplish anything. And I realized at that point where when Père Jeannot gave due credit to God that I had fallen into the secular trap of giving myself glory for the work that was completed and good work for the people who inhabited the poorest country in the Western Hemisphere. In reality, I had lost my spiritual focus. I allowed my pride, my conceit, to filter God out of the process of the good works being achieved for the people of God. I admit, I wanted credit. And as a result, I failed to honor God through the work. I failed to honor God. I failed to worship God, and I failed to give glory to God. Early on in the partnership, when it was articulated that St. Mark's had primary needs, which was one, a new school building, clean drinking water, and access to food, I was told that building a school in such a remote place in Haiti was impossible. And in my pride, I wanted to prove them wrong. And then I could get the job done. In my pride, I forgot the message of Jesus, who reminds us that with God and with God's grace, all things are possible. On April 25th, 2015, as we prepared to dedicate the new school, I was humbled by Père Jeannot's humility and his love for God, his love of God above all things. And I learned a valuable lesson. That's the good news. Now, there was a twist of divine irony. I ended up missing the dedication. God gets the last laugh. Man plans, God laughs. That's what my father-in-law always says. And I missed the dedication. And I missed giving my short homily, which was written in Creole. I missed the ceremony that would mark the opening in the new school. I missed the thank yous, and I missed the congratulations, and I missed the photo ops. I missed it all. I missed it all because one of our nurses became ill and had to be airlifted to the United States. So I wasn't present at the dedication. Nevertheless, I was where I needed to be. I was where God wanted me to be, not where I wanted to be. And at the bottom of the mountain, as I waited for our nurse to be airlifted back to the United States, I took time by myself and finally offered glory to God. I got the message. In this morning's reading from the Acts of the Apostles, after healing the lame man who jumped up and entered the temple, leaping and praising God, Peter addressed the crowd. He addressed the people. You Israelites, why do you wonder at this? Or why do you stare at us as though by our own power and our own piety we had made him walk? The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, the God of our ancestors has glorified his servant Jesus Christ, whom you have handed over and rejected in the presence of Pilate, though he had decided to release him. The primary message here is not about Peter and the apostles doing good works and bringing relief to those who suffer. Of course, such work is very important. However, what is more important, and what I failed to realize back in 2015, was that God's grace empowered to take the man by the hand and lift him up. And the man, as the context of the story informs us, immediately praised God. But we know from Peter's remarks that the bystanders who witnessed the healing miracle tried to give glory to Peter for restoring the beggar's ability to walk. And Peter says, why do you wonder at this? Or why do you stare at us as though by our own power or piety we had made him walk? I admire Peter in this moment because, like Père Jeannot, Peter didn't take credit for the good work performed outside the temple gate. The people are amazed at what they had just seen. A lame man who was begging by the temple gate has jumped up and started leaping about the temple, praising God. Notice that the man doesn't praise Peter and the other disciples, just as Père Jeannot didn't praise me, but praised God. Like Père Jeannot, the man knows the true source of healing and the source of all good things comes from God and not from Peter or any other human. Just as with our own work here at St. Alban's, the goodness and energy comes from the grace of God and not from our own internal source. Peter also knows that the true source of the miracle of this impossible act comes from the living God. And Peter makes no mistake about it when he says, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, the God of our ancestors has glorified his servant, Jesus Christ. Peter, through God, offers justice to a man who is marginalized and limited to begging at the temple gate, and through the power of God, heals the man. Peter then preaches that the source of this miracle comes from God, from the God of our ancestors, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the one true God, who also created the heavens and earth and who created the substance to create the universe. There is no other God, and with God, all things are possible. Peter goes on to explain that God's glory and grace has worked through Jesus Christ, who resurrected from the dead, and God's glory and grace are now working through him and other believers in Christ. He reminds the bystanders that Christ, who they rejected and handed over to Pilate, is the author of creation and the holy and righteous one that God raised from the dead. With God, all things are possible. So let's give glory to God. I find it interesting that Peter doesn't distance himself from the crowd. He doesn't dismiss them because of their misdirected faith or their failure to see the glory of God at hand. Peter doesn't look down upon the crowd and view them as ignorant or assume that they are a hopeless lot. No, he actually invites them to join him in giving glory to God, reminding them that all glory goes to God. In the same manner that Père Jeannot invited the people and me to give glory to God, Peter extends that grace that Jesus Christ had given him even after Peter denied knowing him three times on the night of Jesus' crucifixion. And after Jesus resurrects, he empowers Peter by giving him a second chance to turn back to God and to dedicate himself fully to the service of God. And now in the reading, Peter preaches to the crowd and intimates a certain empathy for the crowd by acknowledging the ignorance of the human condition. He states, "And now, friends, I know that you acted in ignorance, as did your rulers. In this way, God fulfilled what he had foretold through all the prophets that his Messiah must suffer. Repent. Repent, therefore, and turn to God so that your sins may be wiped away." Notice, Peter doesn't say, "Follow me and turn to me and I will lead the way." No, Peter says, "Repent, therefore, and turn to God." He encourages them to turn to God. He encourages them to change their direction so their sins can be wiped away. Peter, as all righteous people do, directs people back to God. Easter season and these 40 days that lead up to Jesus' ascension into heaven reminds us that God's grace is all about us. It's all around. It is God's grace which is given equally to all people and is not given according to our works. It is God's grace that allows us to perform good works, to achieve wonderful things for humanity, and to accomplish things we are told that are impossible. It is God's grace unfolding in the world, whether it is manifested through a food collection for the hungry in Philadelphia, or through building a school in Haiti, or through the resurrection of our Lord and Savior in the ancient city of Jerusalem. No matter what we do, no matter what we do, how good it is, let us acknowledge the divine grace and give glory to God, who even in our ignorance and brokenness makes all things possible. Amen. I invite you to stand as you are able. Let us honor and glorify God as one body as we recite the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation.
We invite you into a spirit of prayer and reflection. O Lord, open our hearts to respect and uplift the dignity of every person. Open our eyes to see the injustices within our society. Open our ears to listen and learn from the experiences of people who are different than we are. Open our hands to serve each other in love. Let us now offer prayers for the good in our world.
For all those who promote peace.
For all those who are kind.
Let us pray.
Lord.
May we offer a prayer of gratitude for being members of a community that provides support for others who suffer in mind, body, or spirit. A community that creates a place of belonging for all people, and a community that aligns its will with God's will. Let us now offer prayers, praising God for Let us pray. Grant us the grace of your goodness and love that we may live devoted lives by performing acts of charity promptly, diligently, and frequently. May our acts of charity help us to care across our differences and lead to peace in our world. Let us now offer prayers for our community partners. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O Heavenly Father, the fountain of all wisdom, enlighten all of us to go forth and to preach your gospel through word, deed, and ministry. May we foster lives of gratitude as we pray for all those who share their gifts in the many ministries offered by St. Alban's Church. Let us now offer prayers for the many ministries we have at St. Alban's. Let us pray.
Lord,
we ask you to comfort and relieve all of those who are suffering in mind, body, or spirit. Give your power of healing to those who minister to their needs. May those for whom we offer our prayers be strengthened in their weakness and have confidence in your loving care. Today, we especially pray for those we now name. Let us pray. We pray with gratitude for the loved ones who have entered your eternal kingdom and rest in your loving care. This morning we remember those whom we now name. Let us pray. O God of love, guide us to care across our differences and to live into our mission as we strive to be the voice, heart, hands, and feet of Jesus Christ. Let us pray. As we welcome God into our heart, may we realize that our prayers are not always meant to transfer outcomes, but to transform us. Amen.
Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ. Have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways. To the glory of your name, amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all of your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, and strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. I invite you to stand. May the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with each and every one of you. Let us share that peace. Good morning.
Good morning.
It's great to see everyone. We welcome our visitors. If you're looking for a church home, we hope you can join us. And if you're interested, we have cards in the pews where you can fill out and give to an usher on the way out. If you're just traveling through and visiting for the day, we hope you have a safe return home. Again, I hope you feel a sense of welcome here. The flowers on the altar, beautiful, and the pedestals were donated today by George and Sue Phillips in honor of their grandchildren, June, George, Lydia, and Zoe. They're also given by Bonnie and Ed Buchak for his parents, Edward and Marion Buchak, and for Bonnie's mother, Faye French Shaw. They were arranged by Julia and Claudia, so thank you for that. Look at that, you're not taking credit. In 2015, I would have taken credit. So on that note, after the 8 o'clock, one of the parishioners said, like, well, weren't you a priest in 2015? Yeah, I said, I was also human, and you know, I got derailed. And that happens to us as Christians, and we have to be careful. So you know, just remember, our priests are supposed to point us to God, not to themselves. So as we move forward. I want to remind you of this Saturday's community cleanup and our partnership with St. James. We're going to meet here at 8 a.m. in the parking lot Saturday at the 20th. If you're interested, there's a sign-up sheet. Please sign up. Let me know or let Kelly know if you are planning to attend. And it's also Earth Day, so one of the things the children are doing today in Sunday school, they're creating a mural of all the beautiful things that God has given us in the earth, and they're going to present that mural, which is going to be an ongoing project in the next few weeks, next Sunday after the Eucharist, and they're going to stay with us after communion and actually help us sing the closing hymn, which is going to be All Things Bright and Beautiful. Isn't that a beautiful hymn? And the Red Cross Blood Drive is next Tuesday, April 23rd. If you're interested in giving blood, you can go on the website. There's information in the bulletin. You can sign up for a time, there's a 1-800 number you could actually call and register, or you can just show up. Again, there's a great shortage of blood. And are there other, I know we have a couple other announcements. Thank you. Any other announcements for the good of the order? Excellent. But I draw your attention to Ron, who's bringing our gifts up for St. James School and St. Mary's Food Cupboard. And let us walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself an offering and a sacrifice to God. lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. But chiefly are we bound to praise you for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. For he is the true Paschal Lamb, who was sacrificed for us and has taken away the sin of the world. By his death, he has destroyed death. And by his rising to life again, he has won for us everlasting life. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days, you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him, you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink this, do this in the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death. We proclaim his resurrection. We await his coming in glory. We offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ and bring us to that heavenly country where with St. Alban and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters through Jesus Christ, our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him. In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Jesus Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, Christ our Passover sacrifice for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast.
Alleluia. Friends, these are the gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you and feed on him in your hearts by faith and with thanksgiving. Thank you. I invite you to stand as you are able, and let us return thanks. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, Savior, Jesus Christ. You have fed us with the spiritual food and the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now to the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. May you have the empathy to see the world through the eyes of others, especially those who suffer, and may you have the grace in your heart to make the stranger your neighbor. May the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you today and forever. Amen.